Hey, what's up, nerdlings? So, even though it started all the way back in the 14th century as a unit of measure before it was actually any kind of currency, it wasn't until the 1700s when Peter the Great finally minted the ruble. And we are here at Rublecon to celebrate all that is and ever was about the Russian currency ruble.
No, Rublecon is a convention that is all about toys and comics and Hot Wheels. First and foremost, it started out about Hot Wheels, and then it kind of blossomed into toys and comics and collectibles and all other things that is amazing. Started from Rublemizers comic shop. So get it right, man.
Come I guess on. I'm in the wrong place.
You are. Something, I don't know if he's actually premiering it or are you filming this?
Yes.
I don't know if this is correct or not.
See the earrings.
Holy guacamole! And some Lunchables in case I get hungry.
Who you gonna call?
They gotta let everybody into this thing, don't they?
Yeah, they kinda do.
Do they have to?
I mean, that's where we both come in, right?
Yes!
I think I've played this Weapons and Warriors set. Like, it's a bad idea because I'm pretty sure it's a working catapult, which means it's a working mess.
I don't think Rambo appreciates you pointing a finger in his face.
Hey, oh, I saw so much war, I'm a little cross-eyed now.
Hey, did you actually buy something for yourself?
I bought something. I buy games even.
I give emergency powers to the Supreme Judge.
So you're the one who ruined everything.
Oh, I gotta go home.
Domo Abrogato General Robot. Domo. Domo.
Best wish ever.
Yeah.
Like he's discoing in there or something. Disco Inferno. know. Look at all the movement it's got. Woo! That's why I love these things. They're so fun.
There you have it, Nerdlings, a quick look at Rublecon. So as Lady Lacey mentioned before, more of a toy convention, collectible convention, although this one had some surprises in store this year. First of all, we love Rublecon. It is like the shortest drive ever for us to ever go to, which
I
really
think it's like
amazing.
Two blocks away.
Define amazeballs.
A little too much with the balls.
Yeah.
We got a couple of pickups here. I actually grabbed a Bucky O'Hare VHS tape just because I feel like it's not that often that you see Bucky O'Hare stuff, and he had a buck on it, so I was like, okay. You know, I actually don't really have any interest in this, but I kind of picked it up in case someone out there does.
Bucky! Captain Bucky O'Hare! Mutants and aliens and toads beware!
I got an NES game. I kind of blame Captain Algebra for this. A few years ago at Mo Game Con, he was looking for Gremlins 2. Now, I had heard good things about this game in the past, but I never had it, and I've actually never played it. But after watching his stream, once he got it, I kind of had it in the pocket of my mind that maybe I should pick this up.
Oh, nice. Sweet. New weapon. Like it.
And the gentleman who had a bunch of NES games for sale there, he actually had some really good prices on his games. In fact, I probably would have gone a little more crazy, except it's like right in the middle of convention season for us. So trying to like balance out those funds and you know, make sure I have some money for the next event. It's kind of the smart thing to do,
it
right?
It is the smart thing to do.
Yeah, man. I think Mitch was beautiful because he's got good brains.
Now, you found a couple of toys, of course, at a toy convention.
Of course I found some action figures. So I got a video game related action figure. I got Booker Ketch! So we got a really cool Booker to go with our Elizabeth and whatever that...
The Boys of Silence with his horn head.
He is complete as far as I know. The only thing that does suck is his guns did not come out of his holster, which would be kind of fun, but he did come with his like grappling hook thing. And the other bad thing is it doesn't spin. It would be kind of cool if this spun a little. But it does not. I think they did a good job for a character that you play firsthand and don't really know what he looks like.
So, funny story about this real quick. We were looking at this, and the price on it, I mean, it was fine, but you're at a convention, you know, you're going to barter and everything. And we were talking about it. We're like, you know, oh, hey, what price do you think you'd be comfortable offering him? Yeah, that's a good price. And then some idiot, some buffoon, some absolute, what would the British call me, a tosser. I lost his hand momentarily. Now, we found it before we purchased it. But it's kind of one of those things, as the previous owner of the toy is helping us look for the hand, you kind of feel like maybe I shouldn't try to bargain with him at this point. So yeah, it cost us some money.
Well, the next action figure I picked up was Sabine Wren from Star Wars Rebels. I was actually looking at her online. We just recently actually started watching Rebels, and I was like, oh, she's a fun character, she's really cool. So I looked up her toy, and her toy is kind of pricey. Kind of expensive. I thought, well, maybe if I ever find her for a good deal. Well, I did. She's out of the box, but complete. And I got her for $10, and she normally goes for about $40 online.
Ooh, that is a good deal.
Yeah, so I was very excited, but she's got both of her guns, and then this like weird little, looks like a hypospray from Star Trek to me, but I'm not sure. But anyway, her guns do come out of the holster. She comes with her helmet. You can put it on her head or off of her head if you prefer. The only thing that kind of irritates me about this toy is she has really cool spiky hair in the show, and they gave her this very slicked down hair, and I know they did that so that her helmet would fit, but I kind of would prefer them to give her two heads.
Just look at it as you got the helmet hair variant. Super expensive, very rare, guys.
Ci piace prendere il vento nei capelli la mattina mentre andiamo al lavoro, eh? In che senso, scusi?
again, one of the big surprises about Rublecon this year was, in the past, once in a great while, you might see some video games. Oh, they're buried over there behind that other stuff. Or, oh, there's actually a single table with a few games on there. This year, though, there were a lot of video games there. Again, quite the tease, because I didn't want to spend all my money at this one convention knowing that I had others to look forward to. But I was picking up some Atari stuff just for fun. Firefly.
I like that TV show.
This is a fertile land, and we will thrive. We will rule over all this land, and we will call it this land.
I don't think it's based on that, but we'll have to confirm.
Curse your sudden but inevitable betrayal.
But this Firefly game came complete in the box, and it's great because not only is this a smaller size box, but even the manual is smaller, which, I mean, just how adorable is that?
It looks like a VHS.
It really does. Yeah, let's,
just a little short.
Just a little shorter. Maybe just a little thinner.
I don't know about that, maybe.
Speaking of Atari games, again, games that I already had, but upgraded because I had them complete in box now, are the SwordQuest games. The gentleman selling these said he actually had the Waterworld one as well.
Dry land is not a myth! I've seen it!
But he was...
I like that movie too.
He was getting that one graded. Okay. I like to open my games and play them though. So anyway, it's great because these are totally complete. First of all, the boxes are in pretty good shape. I mean, there's obviously the tear of getting into the boxes, but it may have helped because he did have them in protectors, which came with them, so that was nice. Of course, what's great is not only are those cartridges in absolute immaculate condition, I mean, look how clean and crisp those labels look, but you've also got the manual, so there's no excuse to not know how to play this Atari game. You got the booklet right there, just read up on it. When it comes to the SwordQuest games, you've got to have the comics. How cool are these? Put out by DC, these are ways to expand the story beyond the scope of the game, since obviously you're not picking up a whole lot of story from the blocks anyway.
It totally looks like what they're meaning it to look like.
You know, actually, I also really love the art in these comics. This is fantastic. I mean, it's gorgeous, it's colorful, very stylized. And you even get the poster that talks about the infamous Sword Quest contest. Yeah, you guys remember this? This was the crazy contest Atari was putting out where you could win actual gold and jeweled items. You know, everything from a goblet to a sword to a philosopher's stone. This stuff was insane. Of course, the contest never came to fruition. I think there have been stories online about exactly what happened to those items, which is very, very sad. Pretty sure one was just melted down. That is not cool at all. Again, I already had the games, but the chance to upgrade them into the full complete sets was awesome. And I even love the artwork on the cover of these, plus that sticker. Play the $150,000 Sword Quest Challenge. Enter by March 15th, 1983.
I think we still have time. It's only 2022.
I got all the time I want. I got a time machine. I can just go back early.
You'll create a time paradox.
All right, so the last thing that we got was a comic book, something that we've actually kind of been waiting on for a little bit.
Yes, we got this from Stone Pie Media and from Matt Decker. It's a new storyline he's doing, a little different than his Zombie Dave storylines, and this was the day he debuted it, and he even signed it for us. But it's a really cute little storyline about these little kids who are superheroes, but it really is all in their imagination. They're just kids running around just pretending that they're superheroes, and their imagination just goes crazy with them. So it's really cute, though.
I mean, first of all, you know, obviously a younger audience, is what it's geared for, but it's a great way to get kids into comics, which is never a bad thing because comics are great and there's so many benefits to reading comics. And it's also just funny to know that this came from the mind of Zombie Dave. I mean, what a transition going from zombies to cute little teddy bears.
Little cutesy.
And Zombie Dave. Together, they fight to protect the world from injustice, corporate... Well, that's unfortunate.
Hey, what does Dave and the management fight for, anyway?
Well, truth be told, mostly it's just to keep you from starting a zombie apocalypse.
Hey!
Well, there you have it. Another Rublecon in the books. Personally, I mean, I love seeing all the toys and comics there. I really do. But I was in hog heaven seeing all of the video games there. Although, again... That tease, I couldn't go crazy, but I feel like I got some great stuff. Let us know in the comments down below if you have any experience with these Atari games, if you've played the SwordQuest games, even not going for, you know, the Bejeweled Challenge, if you're a Bucky O'Hare fan, if you played Firefly, or you're a fan of the show.
Now die! Oh, no God! Oh, dear God in heaven!
You know, do you remember the rules for gremlins? You should. Feed them after midnight. They'll be fine. It's cool.
Which midnight are we going off of?
Oh, here we go again.
Do I have to come up there myself? Do you think the Grimsters can stand up to the Hulkster? Well, if I were you, I'd run the rest of Gremlins too, right now.
Don't forget to like us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Go over to TeePublic because we've got merchandise over there. Check us out on the Retro Refresh. And if we like it, nerdlings,
we nerd it. Booker, catch.
I caught him.
Spidey sense tingling.
I would also like to just point out, nerdlings, someone got more than I did at a convention for the first time, I think, in history of man.
It was a milestone moment,
it
right
It is a milestone
here.
Moment.
Bye, nerdlings. We get to see some of our convention
friends.